Hello friends, today's topic is India as a liberal democracy. So in that title, the first word is democracy. So what is democracy? Democracy can be defined as a set of binding electoral institutions that effectively translate popular views into a public policy. The next term in that title is liberalism. So, what is liberalism? Liberalism is a system wherein institutions effectively protect the rule of law and guarantee individual rights. Now, we will discuss the present scenario of Indian democracy. India got the democracy from United Kingdom. British built and operated most of crucial institutions of liberal democracy in India, like courts, legislature, administrative rules, and free press. Once independent in 1947, Indians inherited these institutions and traditions and built their democracy on them. Even the Congress Party was modeled after a British political party from its liberal nationalist ideology down to its committee structure. Indian courts followed British practice and precedents, often using British law as a precedent. New Delhi Parliament followed Westminster rules and rituals. Nehru's India from 1947 to 1964 can best be described as one-party democracy. During his period, elections were free and fair. Congress Party dominated at every level. After winning around two-third majorities in parliament and in state legislature, Nehru in particular was deeply respectful of liberal institutions and traditions, such as the prerogatives of parliament and press. He supported an independent judiciary. He was obsessive about secularism and religious tolerance. Despite his immense popularity, Nehru allowed dissenting views to flourish and often win the day within both his party and his government. After Nehru, his daughter Indira Gandhi came to the power. She pursued populist policies that were often unconstitutional and certainly illiberal, such as nationalizing bank and abolishing the rights of India's princes. Still, the courts were largely independent, the press free, and religious tolerance sacred. But over the time, Congress Party's commitment to these institutions and values weakened. More importantly, the party declined as a dominant national institution. New challenges rose to fill the space, and the most prominent of them being the BJP or Bharatiya Janata Party. As a result, new voters, almost all from poor, rural, and lower caste background, have entered the political system. These parties have made India more democratic, but they have also made it less liberal. BJP came to the power by denouncing Nehruvian secularism, advocating a quasi-militant Hindu nationalism and encouraging anti-Muslim and anti-Christian rhetoric and action. Religious intolerance is only the first glimpse of the new face of Indian democracy. Massive corruption and disregard for the rule of law have transformed Indian politics. This is the reality of democracy in India. To conclude, Nehru's Congress Party imposed a quasi-liberal order on India in 1950s and 1960s that began withering as new entrepreneurial parties competed for votes using raw appeal to caste, linguistic and religious solidarity. Thank you for watching my video.